Hello, it's Laure. In 1948, a certain Hendrik Casimir predicted the existence of a curious phenomena occurring when two plates are placed very close to each other. Casimir predicted that the two plates should be attracted to each other. We call this effect the Casimir effect after its inventor, but it was considered a fun, slightly useless fact at the time. Now, with the development of nanotechnologies and the shrinking of electronics, the Casimir effect is now an important factor in industrial manufacturing. And a few teams are working on the creation of low-power nanoswitches to revolutionize the field. But let's see what the Casimir effect is. Vacuum is not just empty, it is quantum in nature. As a result, our experimental results vary each time we repeat an experiment. We cannot repeatedly get the same result for an experiment performed in the exact same conditions. This phenomenon is called vacuum fluctuation or quantum fluctuations of the electromagnetic field, and it naturally occurs whether we observe it or not. Some explanations use the concept of virtual particles, which is very useful, but please be aware that these particles are not really created. They simply help us with computations and our understanding. If we place a plate in the vacuum and take measurements very close to it, we observe a reduced amount of electromagnetic fluctuations because of the presence of the plate. If we place a second plate very close to the first one, the space between the plates is affected and less quantum fluctuations of the electromagnetic field will be measured between the two plates. In the rest of the vacuum, however, quantum fluctuations remain the same. As a result, the plates receive more force from the external fluctuations than from the internal ones, and they are pushed together. The vacuum is made up of fluctuating electromagnetic waves, a bit like the waves in the ocean. And like with the ocean, waves cannot be stopped. We can push the analogy further to illustrate the Casimir effect. Let's say we have two ships driving parallel to each other. They each block some of the waves that would hit the other ship, and they receive less waves on the side close to the other ship than from the rest of the water. As a result, they get pushed towards each other. A more physical illustration would be of two mirrors placed close to each other. If the waves are created with variable wavelengths, the external space can create waves of any wavelengths. But the space between the two mirrors can only create wavelengths that can fit. As a result, the external space has slightly more energy than the internal space, and the two mirrors push together. If you learned something, please give this video a like, and if you would like to know more, I invite you to watch another one of my videos on my channel.